All right, let's begin with our Q&A sessions after those big stories with, of course, some great results from some of the top developers of South India. We've got Sunil Kumar on the phone line. Hi, Sunil. Go ahead with your question.
Yeah, hi, Manisha. Thank you for taking up my question on the show. I wish to buy a ready-to-move property or property to be completed by year-end. And I'm an end user. My budget is around 1.5 crore. And looking for a 3 BHK apartment. I have identified a property in Unitech Fresco, which is in Sector 50, Gurgaon. Could you please let me know, should I go for it or buy something else which will be completing by year end?
All right, so you're looking at a property which will be completed by year end. Well, you know, I remember, Sameer, about 7 years ago when I was hunting for an NCR property, the brokers took me to this project of Unitex and showed me close in Fresco. 7 years down, they're still building there. That's my big concern. They promised at the end of the year, is it going to be delivered?
Yeah, actually, you're absolutely right that this is one of the very few projects of Unitech actually which has taken 7 to 9 years to get delivered. Otherwise, they managed to deliver in 5 to 6 years. This project now is on its way to completion.
It's also a huge project. So yeah. I think that's another challenge that it's only getting
it's
completed in phases.
It's a part of a huge township.
Huge township.
Right? Having said that, it's a part of Nirvana County, which is about 300 odd acres. But Fresco per se is not a big project to provide any excuse to Unitech for being, you know, delivering in 7 years a project of this size. It's just that of lack of cash flows which led to this problem. I think this project now will certainly get delivered. Unitech is concentrating on execution. The other thing is that some towers are already ready, where few families are moving in. So that's not my worry. The only worry is that, so the project is decent. The only worry is that there could be a little bit of compromise on quality of construction here, which is my view. Because I know for a fact that close quality of construction was compromised a bit.
Okay.
So what we've
done is... So there is a worry that you have, so might as well avoid it.
So if you like Fresco, you like the floor plan, you've been inside the towers that are completed and you're okay with that, go ahead.
Sure.
But if not, I would recommend you to go in for other projects where the branding of the project is better. Today, branding is playing a big role for future appreciation and the kind of families that move in and the kind of people who live, your neighbors. So we think that we give that much more weightage today. Unitech has got a little bit of a flack because of these two projects. So that's what we will recommend. And
sure.
I'll come to the key data points now. So what we've done is that we've shortlisted Golf Course Extension, which is also a good emerging market other than the Sona Road sectors where this property lies, which is Unitech Fresco. So when we look at Sona Road, which includes Sector 33, going up to 49 in Sona Road, there are 8 projects and 5819 units. No absolute inventory overhangs, so nothing to worry about on that account. If you look at the Golf Course Extension starting with Sector 58 going up to 67A, again 6 projects, you're talking about 3,330 units. Remember, we're only talking about projects getting completed by 2014. That is why there is no inventory overhang. Weighted average price, again, 4 projects getting completed by 2014 in the mid to luxury segment, Sona Road side, 8587 rupees a square feet, and the Golf Course Extension side is 9049 rupees a square feet. Price appreciation trends, of course, Golf Course Extension commanding a much higher appreciation, 69% over the last 2.5 years and 39% for the Sona Road sectors. This is because Golf Course Extension is branded as a market right next to the prime Golf Course Road. So this has given an annualized return of 28%, whereas Sona Road is supposed to be a mid-level, higher than middle, above middle class as I would call it. That's why it's given a 16% annualized return. So the recommendations from our side are Rizana Residency by Tata Housing, a project that got an award also. Sector 59, 9200 to 9500 rupees a square feet is the price. December 2013 is the completion year. Projects available from the resale market. Some towers of this project have already been handed over and some 5 towers are going to be handed over shortly. Orchid Petals by Orchid Infrastructure, this is Sector 48. 8600 rupees a square feet is the price. This project's been ready since 2011 and it's available from the resale market, so no execution risk whatsoever. And lastly, Vatika City Aris by Vatika Limited. This is Sector 49, right on the corner of Sona Road and Golf Course Extension Road. 10,600 rupees a square feet is the price. This has crept up quite a bit. We used to recommend this project, Manisha, at about 7,500-8,000 rupees till about a year back.
2011 was when this project got ready, and this is also available from the resale market.
So mostly anything that you recommend, again, for viewers who have joined us for the first time, I'm sure all our loyal viewers have been hearing this from Sameer and me, that anything in Gurgaon, if you have to go and buy, if it's on the Golf Course Extension Road and in the vicinity of Golf Course Extension Road, will all be available only in resale. It's not going to be available from the developers, because investors come and buy a huge amount of stock and then it comes back into the resale market. So